Merry Christmas 2013. That's what it is. You're not going to see this on Christmas Day because I'm just now getting ready to do it now, and it is Christmas Day. By the time I eat this and get it done and everything, it ain't going to be Christmas no more. Right now, we're starting off with some salmon. Okay, salmon's not traditionally a Christmas dish, but this is like going to be an appetizer. Now, in certain cultures, certain countries, I bet you salmon is probably what they serve at Christmas. Go to the Google and look it up. I bet you Christmas and then salmon, boom, there'll probably be at least 30,000, probably 30 million hits on salmon and Christmas. So, what we're doing with this salmon is going to be cooking it first. I had hoped to cook this yesterday, but didn't get around to it because I'm going to serve it cold. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the salmon, we're going to slice it up, and we're going to put it into rings, huh? Like this, like that, huh? And then we're going to make some scallop mousse in the food processor here. And if you remember from Thanksgiving a year ago, we made a scallop mousse that we made with a salmon mousse. So it's going to be pretty much the same recipe. I'm not going to spend a lot of time talking about that. So we're going to put it in, we'll make the mousse, and then you put the salmon in the ring, and then we're going to put the mousse in there, and we bake it up. So that's how that's going to work. And to start off, we're just going to put some butter around the ring and a butter on a salmon, put it in there. We're going to salt and pepper some of this, season it, and then put it in there and make the mousse. Now, I'm also going to make an herb mayo to go with this. Now, I'm using egg whites for the scallop mousse. Now, I'm not going to make a fresh mayo today because it makes too much. I'm just going to take a regular mayonnaise out of a jar, boom, and add extra lemon, dill, chives, parsley, and shallots. And it's going to make our own herb mayonnaise, and then I'm not going to have to worry about making mayonnaise and making a mess and then having too much of it. Because when you make mayonnaise at home fresh, it doesn't have a long shelf life. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and let's get started. We're going to start with rolling the salmons in here. I'm not going to make these uniform because I haven't really got the time and I already messed it up. So they're going to be all different sizes. I can trim them possibly once they're cold before I serve it and nobody will be the wiser. Well, you will because you watched the video. Put in a sprinkle, pinch and a half, chives, pinch, pretty big pinch of dill, and some shallot, some parsley. And then you drop the egg whites in. Now, if you're going to serve it warm, I would just take a lemon, squeeze some lemon on it, nice and fresh. So I'm just going to cut it like this just to see what it looks like inside. I should have used a different knife, because that's a pretty thick piece mousse. So you don't want to cook it too long, because look, see how the salmon here, this is like 15 minutes. Still very flaky, very moist. Tasty, tasty, tasty. Taste the mousse. Very nice. That much. How much is that? About a cup. Don't have to put salt in again because jarred mayonnaise already has some salt in it usually. And some chives. And some parsley. I am going to add some extra white pepper. And some lemon juice. Half a lemon. A little bit more dill. Dill doesn't seem to be that strong. So I'm going to put dill in. And I'm going to garnish with dill. I hope I remember to garnish with the dill. Boom! Here we go. This is stirring up. More of a sauce, so you want it a little bit thinner. We're going to let this sit in the refrigerator for a couple hours. Adjust the flavor later. Let that sit.